been a hugely busy past couple of days for us in the business. The car industry has gone completely bonkers, launching car after car, including the unveiling of the Nissan Terrano and the all-new Wagoneer Stingray. Here's that and all the other news from Planet Auto.
Maruti launched a premium variant of the Wagoneer this week, and in a spectacular display of ignorance of automobile heritage, or worse, hubris, named it the Stingray. For those of you who don't know, the Stingray was what the 1960s Corvette was called, and this is what it looks like. In any case, back to Maruti. The Stingray will be placed above the current Wagoneer, and besides the new front fascia that houses projector beam units, a new bumper and restyled fog lamps, the rear also changes a bit with new tail lamps and a chrome strip. Under the hood, the engine remains the same with a 1-litre K10 petrol engine that does duty in the regular Wagoneer. Interiors change a bit to all black with a piano finish compared to the two-tone dash in the now lower-end Wagoneer. Prices of the Stingray will begin at 4.9 lakh rupees, all the way up to 4.66 for the top-end VXI variant. In what seems like a reaction to the avalanche of micro SUVs being launched in India, Volkswagen launched the Cross Polo, a variation on the regular Polo but with SUV aspirations. What makes the Cross Polo worthy of the Cross tag? Slightly heightened ride height, thick black body cladding which begins under the chin, continues over the sides and also covers the rear. The wheel arches also get exaggerated, and there's also a front and rear scuff plate with a metallic finish. You've also got roof rails and 15-inch alloy wheels. So far, so good. What's disappointing though is you've got the same 1.2-litre 3-cylinder diesel engine and the same levels of interior trim that you'll find in the top-end Highline variant of the standard Polo. Price you ask, 7.75 lakh rupees ex showroom. Eager also to jump onto the mini SUV bandwagon is Nissan, and towards that end showed off the Terrano in Mumbai this week. Unlike the rebadging game that Renault-Nissan have been playing with cars like the Sunny / Scala or the Micra / Pulse, the Terrano, which is essentially a duster, has changed significantly, at least from the outside, bringing the exteriors closer to Nissan's larger SUVs like the X-Trail and the Pathfinder. You've got sheet metal changes, a new grille, different bumpers, tailgate, headlamps and tail lamps. Engine options remain the same as the Duster though, with a 1.6-litre petrol and a 1.5-litre diesel in two different states of tune. Bookings begin in September and the car will be launched in India in October. Quite on the other end of the SUV spectrum, Audi downgraded its baby SUV, the Q3, to launch the Q3S, a base version that comes with fewer goodies but a smaller price. The Q3S will come with a 2-litre diesel engine with a 6-speed manual gearbox, as opposed to the 177 bhp with a 7-speed automatic that the regular Q3 comes with. Interiors remain mostly the same, with leather seats, cruise control and Audi's trademarked MMI system. What's missing though are the trademarked daytime running lamps. Price? 24.99 lakhs ex-showroom. And finally, Uber luxury car maker Rolls-Royce launched the 4-seater Wraith Coupe in India this week. And before we tell you about the car, here's what it costs. 4.6 crores. Under the hood, you've got a twin-turbo V12 engine putting out 624 bhp and 800 newtons of torque, coupled to an 8-speed transmission that propels this luxurious beast to 100 kilometers an hour in 4.6 seconds, which makes this car the most powerful roller ever built. Other features of the luxury vehicle include mechanical and electrical technologies like heads-up displays, adaptive headlights, keyless boot opening, camera systems, voice activation commands and route assistance. Up until now, if you wanted to buy a Rolls, you'd have to make the trip either to Delhi, Mumbai or Hyderabad. But now Rolls-Royce is expanding its dealer network to include Chandigarh and Ahmedabad.